First of all, I'd like to introduce Marina Pantulis, who's a member of SUESA in the UK and has also played a really major part in establishing the Greece Solidarity Campaign. Thanks, Marina.
We won. Now, I want to tell you a little bit about that night and how it felt. Of course, it felt great. We were all very moved and we were all in the streets with some of you, people from Britain, people from Spain, people from France. But as we were moving in the streets, after we knew the results, I met one of my comrades, an old comrade. So I said to him, how do you feel? And he was obviously moved. He said, well, I don't really know. I was never on the side of those that they win. I've never won before. And he was right. It was a very strange thing. On the one hand, we were very enthusiastic. We won. But on the other hand, it was a little bit surreal. You had all these hundreds of people singing the Bandiera Rosa. I mean, who would ever believe that in the middle of Athens, without police attacking us, we would be singing the Bandiera Rosa. It was great. It was a fantastic night. And it was a night for all of us. What it was amazing about that night, it was that there were people there from France, our comrades from the Solidarity Campaign UK, people from Italy, people from all over Europe. And this was a victory for all of us. This was the night that we could all together say, we won. That was the feeling. 25th of January, all the people of Europe won together with Syriza. Woo! I was coming from Norwich, and then I was thinking, as I said, that well, we win every time we give a struggle, though. Little by little, with every little battle that we give, we win. Step by step, little by little. But that night was a very special night. It was a night where, for once, we could stand up and say, yes, now I can feel it. Now we have won, and it is significant. And this is what we should remember about that night and about this gathering. Now let me tell you a little bit about what I think we want. In the first instance, in Greece, what happened with the victory of Syriza, it was a slap at the face of those that they imposed the lending agreement and those who brought to their knees the Greek people by imposing austerity, by creating a huge unemployment, by imposing severe taxation. But it wasn't only that. It was much more than that. It was not only about renegotiating the agreements and making the conditions in Greece better. It was about demanding a change, a radical change, a change against any logic that neoliberalism has imposed across Europe. This was the second thing. But I think it was even more than that. And this is where Europe comes in. This is where all of us have a role to play. It was a message from all of us, not only Greeks, but British, German comrades, Spanish, Italians, that we are not going to take what they are doing to us. We are not there to be played with, and we were going to hit back. This was another thing that the victory of Syriza meant for us. So this was our victory. And now, still, we have a lot to do. And we have to carry this victory. And this is not an easy thing. First of all, it is not an easy thing of how we will manage this victory internally in Greece. I don't know if this was part of the news in Britain. I just came last night from Greece. But as the previous, from the Conservative Prime Minister left, he left the house where the Prime Minister is, number 10 or the equivalent of number 10, they took with them everything. Toilet paper. This is who they are.
Austerity.
Toilet paper.
I mean, if they could destroy, they have already destroyed them. But if they could destroy even more the little bit that it is left in Greece, they are going to do it now. They have no dignity, they have no pretense of who they are, this is who they are, and they are going to fight us all the time. This is what they are doing now. They are preparing. So, in Greece, as Greeks, we have to carry our victory. And this is not an easy thing. We have to stand strong. And we are going to face threats, and we are going to face their blackmails, and we have to stand strong so we don't make big compromises. We have to stand strong against our own fears and our own weaknesses. We are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. We are not perfect as organizations, as individuals, as activists. But this is what is our next task, to create structures that they will make the people our partner in this victory, our supporters. We have to devolve power and bring the people in. Not the Greek people I'm talking about, but not as our voters anymore, but as our partners who will stand with Syriza and we will go on fighting for a radical break, for a change, a big change in the political system. Today, our Prime Minister, our comrade, he outlined what are our priorities. Our priorities is to clear the country from corruption, clientelism, destroy the old privilege, the vested interest, and so on. This is our first aim. Our second aim is to renegotiate the debt, to destroy the lending agreement, a debt that everybody by now, no matter what they say and what their pretense is, everybody knows that it is not viable, and this is clear across Europe. But the big question, this is our two main priorities, but the big question that everybody is asking these days is, can Syriza deliver? This is what the text I received said. Can Syriza really deliver? It seems that this is the 1 million question. Well, my answer to that is that Syriza will deliver if the people demand that Syriza is going to deliver. This is why we want the people with us, we want the people as our partners. I was discussing with a comrade before and other people today, and they were asking me about the independent Greeks that we formed the government with them. So, they said, what is Syriza doing? Is Syriza going to deliver? Well, it's an interesting question. But I say something, comrades, and I will say, because I feel it very deeply. If you want Syriza to deliver, don't ask me this question. Don't ask Stathis this question. Go to the Communist Party of Greece that we have invited so many times to be in the direct government, united with us, and they refuse. Your question should be addressed to them. Why they didn't unite the left? Why they are not our partners in government? Not Syriza, them, Communist Party, and anybody else who believes that they will keep their purity, they are better leftists than we are, and then we stand on their side and be clean and criticized. So these questions, comrades, to the Communist Party of